Alex, and my cosplay handle is Losandela. So I had to take it. This is take two. You probably won't see that because I'm probably gonna try and edit that in, maybe. But this is my tutorial on Feo Ul, its wings primarily, and all the foam pieces. So this is baby's first video, so bear with me. There's probably gonna be like some jump edits, and I'm really shy in front of the camera, so like if it just looks like that I'm looking elsewhere, yeah, I'm just a little nervous, but I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. I'm gonna have to figure out a different way. This is for like post edit, but I'm gonna have to find a different way, like maybe film, because I felt like I was kind of out of focus for most of it, but we'll see. All right, thank you. Bear with me. All right. So this is, and I'm gonna step back because I think you may not get this all on camera, but so everybody's seen pictures of these before. There's a bunch of pictures, but I don't think anybody truly grasped how like big they are, because this is, I'm like 5'7", and so if you stand them just like at the base, it's way above my head. These wings, now I'm bringing them close. These wings were made out of 10 millimeter foam, not the HD kind, just the regular kind that I got from TNT Cosplay. Basically what I did was I freehand sketched everything, and I went and burned in like every detail, so where the black and stuff is where it's all burnt in. That process took, I want to say, probably about a week. I don't know. It's all a blur now. So I took, and I'll have like a video. I think I'll probably just edit in a part where I show you what paints I use. I use the Createx airbrush paint. If you ever decide to do that, just make sure you thin it out with your airbrush thinner, because otherwise it'll clog your airbrush, and I learned that maybe a month in, so don't be me. So I started with orange, and I did orange from here to about here, and then I did red. And so what I did was, when I did the red, I sprayed at the line, and then I did careful like a light spray to give it more of like a blending effect. So you don't actually get to see that much on this wing, but on the other side, and actually, let's see. I'm trying to see what wing is with us. Okay, you can kind of see it here, where it kind of blended into the blue. I'm really hoping I'm holding that in front of the camera right, but you can kind of see where it blended in front of the blue and blended out. Same thing with the pink and everything. This took, all in all, this is 24, I think it's 24, 21 or 24, pretty sure 24 sounds right. It's 24 separate pieces of foam glued together. So you have, and so for this piece, it's just all one big, well, okay. For this piece, it's all one big piece. And for this piece, it's this big piece. So one big piece. I believe this is, I think this is actually another 10 millimeters. perhaps when I get inside, I'll show you like the rough draft, because the earlier draft of this was like 8 millimeters, but it was way short. And then you have the separate wing pattern here, airbrushed orange here, and then you have this one on top, airbrushed here. So you can see, like right here, I don't mind showing my messy stuff, you can see. Hopefully you can see it. You can see right here where it's all the layers smacked together. Smashed, squished, smushed together. Probably gonna, yeah. So in the front, I'm gonna have to hold this kind of carefully. Hopefully you can see it, I don't know. Like, might be too close, might be too far. So same thing with this wing, kind of ombre out. Then you have these two pieces right here, and then you have this one half wing portion that is made out of 4 millimeter HD foam that I got from SKS Props. Yeah, same routine, burned it in. Painted the outside edges with black and airbrushed orange. For this wing up here, which I might have to do some fancy stuff to get to so you can see it. Hopefully you can. So this wing here, it is coming apart, poor baby. The last time that I wore these, they got kind of beat up, so they're kind of having a rough time. But these are three separate pieces in total. So this is the base piece right here, and then you have this piece right here, that upper layer, like airbrush orange, and then this main layer that comes out. These, if I believe correctly, are also the HD foam, 4 millimeter, spray painted it. It's kind of like a yellow gold Createx, airbrush, paint. And, actually I think it's orange. That might be, no, I'm pretty sure it's yellow. It just kind of, oh yeah. Okay. Yeah. So for this part and, another part, like I'll show you on the other wing, but for like this part, there's yellow, so I spray painted yellow underneath, and then I spray painted orange on top of this to give this kind of yellow orangey color, like if you ever seen Monarch Butterflies, kind of like that pretty much. Maybe I'm wrong, I don't know. A lot of questions that I do get is how I managed to mount this bad boy, and I'm going to tell you. I kind of had to really do it a little archaically. I think I'm holding this too high. Hold on. Let's see. Am I holding this too high? Nope. Okay. So I kind of had to, mount this kind of archaically. Like, I wouldn't recommend doing this at all. Just saying. Because... it really was a pain in the butt, and it was kind of a lot of the stages of this particular piece was, you know, you do it or you have to redo the whole thing over again. So what I did was, I'll come a little close here. So what I did is I went and drilled in through both sides of the foam. So, you have 4 millimeter, a 10 millimeter, 2 4 millimeters, and then the 10 that's back here. So you have to have a pretty long screw. So I drilled all the way through, and I went and I cut a PVC pipe. I can't remember how long this is, but I can totally like add it to the end of the video or something, or put it in the description. But I cut a length of PVC pipe I drilled in the middle of the PVC pipe, or like right towards the end. And so what I did is I added, I don't think you can see it, but I added washers to like where the screw is, and then there's washers underneath, you can't really see it, so that like the foam doesn't tear. And then on the other side, I have two washers and now I can't think of the name of it, but a washer. No. Okay. I'm sure I'll figure that out. So for this wing, this is not the wing that has, yes it is. Okay, so yeah, maybe. There's one wing, and I think it's this one. It might be the other one. Pretty sure it's this one. Where you have to be kind of careful if you do this route. I don't recommend doing this route, but if you do and you have to, just make sure that you don't do what I did and have the screw point too close to the end of the foam, because what happens is, like, it's slightly windy today, so you can see that the wind is moving the foam a little bit. What happened to my wings is that when I went to AWA last November, it was pretty windy that day, so the wind just ripped the screw, ripped the foam away from around the screw. So the easy way that I fixed it was that I contact cement glued it to the, like I said, I wouldn't recommend doing this, but the easy way that I fixed it is I contact cement glued it to the pipe, and then I gently put the washer over it. Like I said, it was one of those fixes. The ideal fix for me is to just redo these two parts and then try again later. This wing's kind of more of my crowning example of like what it's supposed to look like, I guess. I just feel like this wing looks better. I don't know, I'm pretty biased. So anyways, same thing with the mounting, everything like that. All right, so. So this bad boy, this is the flower bud that is on the back. It's a little flattened now, but this one took me, I want to say this piece took me like first try. I feel like I'm lying, but I know I completed it in like a few hours, and I was like confused because I felt like it shouldn't have took me like that. I don't say like that long. I mean, like normally when I do something from like concept-y, it takes a while for me to do, but like this piece was just like, bam. She is coming apart a little bit, but I'll show you on the back. I have two strips of Velcro to secure it to the mount, which I'm going to show in a little bit. So each piece is, I believe, this isn't two, I'm gonna say this is four. Some of this doesn't look like it's four though. There's a mix of regular foam and HD foam here. So, but this is primarily 4mm foam. Same principle, burnt the details in, airbrushed it orange, and see each individual piece, like I can peel it apart, so each individual piece is like glued together. Like I said, it got flattened out because the original was more like a flower, so it was more like that, but that's what it looks like up close. I hope I'm showing it right. I'm probably gonna have to reshoot some of this, I feel like, because I'm doing this by myself, and I'm pretty sure like half of the stuff is probably out of focus. So, like I said, baby's first video. So this is the flower bud. This is me. So the last piece I worked on was the front flower bud and flower piece, and it's coming apart a little bit, primarily because of the glue. Like I said, I'm not like a super professional cosplayer, but seal your paint. Don't be me. This is not sealed. When I was rushing to complete this for AWA last year, I didn't seal this. Whoops. But this is a hydrangea pink, I think. I gotta find the paint bottle. It's somewhere in the chaos of my room. But so these are basically just two separate pieces like glued together. All this was like freehand pattern, so this one in particular, this like pattern in particular, I do actually have, like I found it. So I don't know if anyone will ever need it. I don't know. I don't think too many people are crazy to like build, I don't know, 6-foot, 7-foot wings out of foam. Maybe somebody out there wants to do it. That's pretty much what this is for. Even if you don't want to build it for foam, maybe it'll help give you some ideas when you decide to do cloth or whatever it is you want to do, if you want to do Feo Ul. This is kind of primarily because I'm primarily filming this is because I said that I was going to months ago, did not, and I'm trying to do this thing where now I kind of document how I do stuff. Now I primarily like follow other people's patterns, but lately I've had to just kind of freehand stuff. So I figure, like, you know, I would help out anybody that gets stuck. So yeah, I feel like I just went off on a bit of a tangent. I probably did. I'm really good at doing that. So these pieces, so this is from this piece on is a whole piece, and there's like a bug on it, but whatever. This is pretty sure this is 4mm HD foam. And pretty much I just burnt the patterns in here and airbrushed it. I want to say this was probably the easier piece to do, in terms of like surface area. It's not like the wings that took me like weeks or a whole day. Like I said, for Feo Ul, it took me about 3 months, 3.5 months. So the project itself took me, I should probably like talk in the camera. The project itself took me about 4.5 months, and the wings took me about 90% of that time. Mostly just because of the airbrushing, really. Probably won't do that again. So the last thing that I will talk about is this. This is pretty, for the lack of the word, I'm pretty sure there's better harnesses out there than this. This is just the one that I use for like everything, because my friend Lamont helped me make this one. So I'm just kind of like, I can't really cut out wood, so like I don't have a harness for everything. So like this harness has been for Mercy. I've used it for Pink Mercy, and I've used it for Feo Ul. And if I ever redo Devil Mercy, I will probably retrofit this for Devil Mercy. Pretty handy. Basically, it's just a block of wood. So what I did is, for the back, I just cut out some super thick foam. I'm trying to remember what size, because TNT Cosplay Supplies sells these. It's the super thick, like really thick foam. I was using it for white mane,
but we won't talk about that. So I got some super thick foam to put on the back. You really want to do that. And then I covered up the screw holes because you can see a little bit that the screw holes protrude out from the foam because they have to be butts aligned. You really want to do this because you don't want it to obviously dig in your back, but you obviously don't want it to tear your costume. So you just want to make sure that you cover these screw holes. It's probably pretty common sense, but I don't know, like, I didn't really think about these things so much when I like started doing cosplay. Like, there's a lot of little nuancy things that you just kind of don't think about, or maybe it's just me, probably me. So like I said, yeah, in the front, I spray painted it black, but to be honest with you, you really can't see much of it because the bud, like, you wouldn't even see the color, so like, doesn't matter what color you put. Reason being here is that the bud just pops on like that, and see, and so you can't really see like anything. And I have to kind of give it to myself, like, when I have it on, and there's some pictures of Instagram where like I actually have it on in costume, and I think there's a couple where I have it on outside of costume, but like, I just have it on trying it on. You really can't see these pieces unless I lift up my arms. So like, if I'm sitting normally and like, blah, 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 I'm not gonna put it on today, but if I'm sitting normally, you can't, like, standing normally, just like hands to my side, you can't really see the white pieces unless I lift my hand. So there's some of my professional pictures and even my candid pictures where you can see like one of these, but I really made it so that the magic is not lost. But basically they just kind of fit in as normal. You kind of have to jury rig it. Like I said, I really had to like jury rig the thing together. A lesson for anybody. I'm pretty sure most people that watch this have some cosplay experience, but I learned this big lesson with Feo Ul, is that you're always, if you're gonna do something like this, you always want to like build the mount system in tandem, or just like either build it in tandem or just build every piece like it's going to be mounted, and then you test. You always test. You test fit, you test mount. You do not do like I did the entire project and then be like, okay, I'm gonna mount these wings together, and then have the original plan fall apart, and then there's worry and there's panic because there is a cosplay deadline and you're freaking out. Yeah, don't do that. Don't be me. Just definitely learn my lesson. And for any newbies that watch this, God forbid, always test your stuff. Like, test it, especially before you paint it, because I feel like with painting, if you have to sand anything, like if you already painted it and then you have to do it, then there's kind of like a point of no return thing. And yeah, you don't want that. All right, I feel like I've been talking too much, but yep, this is it. Thanks for listening to my TED Talk. It wasn't really a TED Talk, but I'm really awkward in front of the camera, so I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial, and if you did, I will be having a video about Valeria and some of the things that I had to do. I'm using Kim Patz's tutorial, but for a lot of it, I kind of just ended up using her tutorial as a reference, which is not an aside against her or anything like that. It's just for some pieces, I'm like, you know, I needed more elaboration, so I ended up having to make my own pieces. So I hope that if anybody does it in the future, like, I hope that the places that I got stuck in, like the videos that I do, it helps people. It's pretty much all I want to do is help people. So, all right, thanks for listening. Bye.